But it's not just the tune which is different here. Vivaldi compresses the opening material, leaving three bars out, and increases the rate and the pattern of harmonic change. The tempo hasn't changed, the underlying pulse is still the same, yet the pace seems somehow to have quickened. The feeling of movement has increased. Why? How? Well, here we come to one of the most important and subtle distinctions in music, the difference between pace and tempo. Tempo, the actual note-to-note speed of the music, is established by the main pulse of a piece, and, like the heartbeat, this is something more or less constant. Pace, on the other hand, is the impression of speed, which takes us into the realm of psychology. How time flies, we say, when you're enjoying yourself. And when we're bored, we complain that time drags. The minutes felt like hours. But none of this is a function of the clock. A minute is a minute is a minute. An hour is an hour. Not a second more, not a second less. The impression of speed in music is determined basically by the rate of change. It may be simply a matter of harmony. The more harmonies or chords you have within a certain space of time, the faster the movement will feel. If there's only one harmony or chord per bar, the impression of movement will be slower. And the same applies to melody. If there are only two main notes within a given space, the impression of movement is obviously slower than when there are four main notes. So, back to Vivaldi. And we pick up where we left off with a beautiful example of this contrast between tempo and pace. While the pace of the solo violin is broadened, the pace of the accompanying harmony, the windswept grasses, increases to the rate of one harmony per bar, a rate three times faster than in the opening section. And this combination, with its fleeting flashes of tension between soloist and orchestra, gives the whole passage a feeling of emotional depth which rises to the level of genuine pathos.